some money right now. I do. What's up, beautiful people? My name is Lakeisha Pinckney, and it's such a pleasure to have you stopping by my channel today. If you are new, make sure that you subscribe because you're going to get the good goods today. If you are a subscriber, thank you for being a part of the tribe. I truly appreciate you so much. Guys, today we're going to talk about 5 ways to save money right now. I mean, like right now. Right now. Let's go. I don't know if y'all follow Chris Hogan, but he teaches people how to be millionaires. Please check him out. And I know that I've been talking about getting out of debt, getting out of debt, getting out of debt. But with our current situation, I think we need to put a pause on it. Because Chris Hogan says we need to put a pause on it. And I agree with him. Now is the time to get your money up. Get some cash going. Put it in your savings account. Now is the time to put a halt on paying off that debt. Especially if your resources are limited. You know? And even if you have resources, we don't know what the outcome of this thing is going to be. We probably have a whole nother year of being in quarantine, of all this craziness going on. So it's time to get your cash. Like my daddy always used to say, money talks, walks. So you want to keep your money. Cash is king. Right now, we need to protect and conserve. Protect our health. Taking care of your body. Wearing your mask. Taking your vitamins. Just ensuring that your physical self for yourself and your family is maintained. And conserve. Conserve your financial resources. That's your money, honey. Conserve that. I know that you all have been putting that extra money on that credit card a month, putting that extra money on that mortgage. I've been doing the same thing, putting extra money on things to pay them off. That's my student loan. But now is the time to say, screw, put a pause on it. Just pay that minimum. Pay that minimum and take that extra, put it in your savings account. Take that extra, put it somewhere safe. So that you can get your hands on it. You want to stack your cash. You want to stack your cash, build your savings account, your emergency fund, whatever you have to do. Stack it, stack it, stack it. So now's the time to stack your money. I ain't going to lie, y'all. I got to get on track with those numbers, crunching those numbers, and making sure that I put that money in savings account. Because it's so easy to fall into, oh, I got extra money. Woo-hoo-hoo, I got extra money. So make sure you are strategic. I'm going to be fully transparent with you. That is one of my struggles. Crunching those numbers. Now, I do okay with cutting stuff out, but crunching those numbers and making sure that I allocate that money to go someplace else, it has been a struggle. So I'm just being honest. I'm doing my best. I got to get back with writing things down like I should, because now that my stuff is on auto pay, I just let it auto pay. And I don't really look at it like I should, but I need to. I need to do better. Cutting down to those essentials only, to those things that you need. Like Dave Ramsey talks about your four walls. You only need to make sure you have your house, you're paying your mortgage, your rent every month. Make sure you have transportation because you got to go to work, especially if you have to leave to go to work. Make sure you have food. Make sure you're taking care of your utilities. Those four things are very important. Now, granted, I know we want to work out, but you don't necessarily need a gym membership. You can work out at home. So that's something you can cut out if you need to. Lawn services. Now, right now, because y'all, I don't like cutting grass. I tried when I was a kid. I just could not stand cutting grass. So I make sure I keep money for that. For my lawn guy, he is great. Him and his son come every couple weeks and they take care of all that stuff. But if it gets to the point where I cannot afford that, I'm going to cut that out too. So you have to see where you are with your finances. What can I roll with right now? What can I cut out? How can I reallocate my funds? That's very important. Cut out extra things from your budget, okay? Now, like right now, I can pull my money from childcare, aftercare. That's money I can use. Bam, put in my savings account. Gas that I'm not spending. Bam, that's money that I can use. Put in my savings account. Eating out. Bam, that's the money I can use. Put in my savings account. You can also sell things to make extra money. I sold a ton of stuff last year on Facebook Marketplace, like a ton. All my baby stuff, stuff in the house. So guys, look in your attic, look in your garage, under your bed, in your spare bedroom, in your closet. Look everywhere, because I promise you, you have between $500 to $1,000 worth of things in your house that you can sell and make money, boom, like that in a week. Just pull them out, take pictures of them, upload them on Facebook Marketplace. You got Let Go. You got Mercari. You have Craigslist, eBay. You got a ton of things. Plus, sell your stuff and get money, bam, today. Today, you can call up your mortgage company. Say, hey, can I have a deferment? Because like right now with the pandemic, people are not getting penalties. Even though, you know, you still gonna have to pay that. But it's gonna be tacked on to the end of your loan. So if that's of interest of you, go ahead and do that. Now for me personally, I don't plan on doing that. Like right now, I'm okay. But if things get crazy, I'm definitely gonna call them. Hey, can you tack that mortgage for the next 2-3 months on the end? Do that. That's 3 months. Because your mortgage may be $9,000, $2,000 a month. That's the money you put in your savings account. Save that money. Don't worry about getting out of debt right now. Save that money. Stack your money. Now is the time to pad your savings account. Pad your liquid account. Having cash on hand is key. Cash is king. Having cash on hand is key. All right, mommy, you made it to the end. Because, you know, here's some tips for you. Because it's hard out there in them streets. We got to realize as mamas, a lot of times people just want to skip taking care of ourselves. But it's like being on an airplane. What's the first thing they tell you to do when stuff gets crazy? Put the mask on yourself. Because if you fall out, how you going to help your kids? You can't breathe. So, mom, you got to take care of yourself. Pamper yourself. You know, you're saving money because you're not getting your mani-pedis. But do your own mani-pedis. Bring that nice bubble bath. Relax. Get something good to eat. Get you something good to drink. Watch a TV show that you enjoy by yourself. Make sure you are up on your vitamins. Eating healthy. Make sure you do that. Because you it's just you. You got to take care of yourself so that you can be able to take care of your kids. I have given you permission to not be perfect. Because I know I did struggle at the beginning of this pandemic. Like, oh, my kids eat too much cereal and sandwiches. They watch too much TV. It's okay. Everybody's struggling right now. Don't stress out. Now is not the time to be super mom. Now is the time to be the best mom you can. You are in straight survival mode. If you need help, throw out that lifeline. Ask for some help. There are so many mamas out there that are taking their kids into stores when they shop. And I don't do that. Call up a friend. Ask them if they can come over and watch your kid. Like, mama, you got to work. Nobody else is here but you. Your kids run around crazy. Feel free. Turn on Disney Plus if you still have it, if it's still in your budget. Put in a cartoon. You got to give them time to themselves anyway so you can get done what you need to get done. Storyline Online. Oh my gosh, that is an awesome website. I was using it before the pandemic. It has stories that are read by celebrities. They are so great. One of my favorites is The Hula Hoop Queen, read by Oprah Winfrey. That one is the bomb. Check that out. Storyline Online will help get you through. I hope y'all can use these tips because, ladies, we got to keep ourselves together because we're going to make it to the end. If you have just watched this video and you made it to the end, please make sure you subscribe if you have not already subscribed. I would truly appreciate it. And I'm going to have somewhere around here some other videos that are going to help you with saving money, stacking your money. 20 things that I stopped buying. 5 streams of income. Check those videos out. They're going to be floating around here someplace. But thank you guys so much for coming by. I truly appreciate you. Remember, take care of your money and your money take care of you. Love you guys. Mwah.